Hello friends, this is question series for UPSC prelims 2019. So let's get started. This is about me. This is part 4 of this series. We have completed 3 parts. Do watch them. Okay, so question number 36. Unnat PBW 343 is a variety of, so it is a variety of wheat. Okay, so answer here is C, wheat. Okay, so new wheat variety Unnat PBW 343, resistant to leaf rust and stripe rust, was developed by PAU Ludhiana through marker assisted back cross breeding approach. Okay, moving ahead, question number 37. Consider the following statements with respect to Global Green Growth Institute. Okay, it was launched at the 2010 United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change UNFCCC conference held in Cancun, Mexico. Okay, it is a treaty-based international intergovernmental organization dedicated to supporting and promoting strong, inclusive and sustainable economic growth in developing countries and emerging economies. Okay, so answer here is B, 2 only. First is wrong. Okay, so answer is B. The Global Green Growth Institute is a treaty-based international organization headquartered in Seoul, South Korea. Okay, GGGI was first launched as a think tank in 2010 by Korean President Lee Myung-bak and was later converted into an international treaty-based organization in 2012 at the Rio+20 summit in Brazil. And the most important thing to note here is that India is a partner state and not a member state. Okay, so moving on, question number 38. Consider the following statements with respect to Lytton River. Okay, this river was in news very recently. Okay, so it runs a course through the Ladakh. Okay, it flows along the entire length of Pakistan to merge into the Arabian Sea. Okay, so here both the statements are wrong. So answer is D, neither one nor two. Okay, so Lytton River flows through Meghalaya. Okay, and the miners were trapped after water from the nearby Lytton River gushed into the illegal rat hole mine at San area in Lumthari village. Okay, so if you are following newspaper, reading newspaper, you might be knowing about this incident. Very unfortunate incident it was, that some miners who were there doing rat hole mining, and they were trapped when water from this river gushed into that mine, and they all were dead. Okay, so moving on, question number 39. Consider the following statements about sambar. It is native to the Indian subcontinent only. Okay, it is listed as least concern on the IUCN red list. Okay, so I told you yesterday also that whenever such kind of words only, always, all, never, not come, you just become alert, because most of the time they are wrong. So here also it is wrong, and second statement is also wrong. So answer is C, both. Answer is D, neither one nor two. Okay, so because you have to find correct statement, so both are incorrect. Okay, so answer is D. The sambar rusa unicolor is a large deer native to the Indian subcontinent, southern China and Southeast Asia, that is listed as vulnerable, not least concern, okay, on the IUCN red list since 2008, and population have declined substantially due to severe hunting, insurgency and industrial exploitation of habitat. Okay, moving on, question number 40. Katarnia Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary is located in, okay, so it is located in Uttar Pradesh. So answer is A. Okay, the Katarnia Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary is a protected area in the upper Gangetic Plain in the Uttar Pradesh, India, and covers an area of 400 km square in the Tarai of the Bharaich district. Okay, so moving on, question number 41. Consider the following statements. RBI transfers the surplus fund to the government after keeping all provisions and contingency buffers according to its statutory mandate under section 47 of the RBI Act. Okay, central government has formed Bimal Jalan committee to review the RBI's existing economic capital framework, ECF. Okay, so we have to find correct statements. Second one is wrong, first is correct. So answer is A, one only. Okay, so answer here is A. The Reserve Bank of India has formed an expert committee under former governor Bimal Jalan. Okay, so RBI has formed the expert committee, not central government, Bimal Jalan, to decide the appropriate level of reserves that the regulator should hold. Okay, and RBI transfers the surplus to the government after keeping all provisions and contingency buffers according to its statutory mandate under Section 47 of the RBI Act. The reserves are meant for unforeseen contingencies, including depreciation in the value of securities, risk arising from exchange rate operations, and other systemic challenges. Okay, so moving on, question number 42. Net metering is sometimes seen in the news in the context of promoting the what? Okay, so use of pipe natural gas in kitchens of household, no. Installation of CNG kits in motor cars, no. Installation of water meters in urban households, no. Production and use of solar energy by households consumers. Okay, so this is correct. So answer here is D. Okay, so answer is D. Net metering allows consumers who generate some or all of their own electricity to use that electricity anytime instead of when it is generated. This is particularly important with renewable energy sources like wind and solar, not just solar energy, okay, wind also, which are non-dispatchable. Okay, moving on, question number 43. Project Sangda is associated with snow leopard, no. Road connectivity, no. Interlining of rivers, no. So answer is B, waste management. Okay, so answer is B. Project Sangda, initiated by the district administration, aims at sustainable waste management in rural areas of Leh district and city. For the first time, the project turned the waste into revenue generating goods such as curtains, toys, cushion covers. Wine or beer bottles and other broken glasses were reused in construction of roads and buildings by local construction companies. Okay, so moving on, question number 44. Florianopolis Declaration is associated with Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, no. Regional Integrated Multi-Hazard Early Warning System for Africa and Asia, no. International Whaling Commission. Yeah, this is correct. So answer here is C. So answer is C. On September 13, 2018, IWC members gathered in Florianopolis, Brazil, where they discussed and rejected a proposal by Japan to renew commercial whaling. Through the Florianopolis Declaration, it was concluded that the purpose of the IWC is the conservation of whales, and they would now safeguard the marine mammals in perpetuity and would allow the recovery of all the whale populations to pre-industrial whaling levels. Okay, so moving on, question number 45. Consider the following statements with respect to Hongyun project. If you remember, I have taken the name of this project in yesterday's lecture also. Okay, so first statement is, it is led by China Aerospace Science and Industry Corp. Yeah, this is correct. It aims to provide broadband internet connectivity to users around the world. So this is also correct. So answer is C, both 1 and 2. Inaugurated in 2016, the project is led by China Aerospace Science and Industry Corp. with a vision to build a space-based communication network that is able to offer broadband internet connectivity to users around the world, especially in remote and underserved regions. Okay, so they will put some 150 communication satellite in Earth's lower orbit. Okay, lower orbit means lower Earth orbit is at an altitude of 160 to 2000 kilometer. Okay, and through these satellites, they will provide broadband connectivity, and it is expected to become operational by 2022. So moving on, question number 46. Consider the following statements with respect to Pekka rebellion. Okay, this was also so much in news in 2018. It was not supported by the tribals. Okay, again, these not word has come, so this statement is wrong. It was led by Bakshi Jagbandhu Vidyadhar. Okay, sorry for the mistake. This is Jagbandhu. Okay, so answer is B, 2 only. So answer is B. Predating what has been popularly regarded as the first war of independence in 1857, the Pekka Bidroh, Pekka rebellion of 1817 in Odisha briefly shook the foundations of British rule in the eastern part of India. Pekkas were essentially the peasant militias of the Gajapati rulers of Odisha, who rendered military service to the king during times of war while taking up cultivation during times of peace. So they were basically peasant, And during times of peace, they were doing cultivation, and during times of war, they used to render military service. They unfurled the banner of rebellion against the British under the leadership of Bakshi Jagbandhu Bidyadhar as early as 1817 to throw off the British yoke. The tribals of Ghumusar, part of present-day Ganjam and Kandhamal districts, and other sections of the population actively took part in it. So as you can see, tribals also took part in this. Okay, moving on, question number 47. India's growth story from the eve of independence to the liberalization phase is largely termed as Hindu rate of growth. What it refers to? Okay, non-inclusive growth story of India before 1990s liberalization? No. Religious belief of the successive government right from the independence? No. Irrational development agenda driven by majoritarian society? No. The phenomena of sluggishness in growth rate of Indian economy before 1990s? Yeah, this is correct. So answer here is D. Okay, so answer is D. Hindu rate of growth was coined to refer to the phenomena of sluggishness in the growth rate of Indian economy. Okay, the term, which owes to Professor Raj Krishna, member Planning Commission, captured popular imagination and was used synonymously to describe inadequacy of India's growth performance. Okay, so moving on, question number 48. Assam shares its borders with which among the following states, country? So this is very good question. In this, your mapping will be tested. Okay, so Sikkim is not there. Okay, so easily we can eliminate A and D option because it is having Sikkim, and in B and C, 4 and 5 are common. Okay, so now we have to only see 2. So 2, Myanmar is not there because Assam is on little bit upside and Myanmar is on the eastern side of India. Okay, so answer here is B, 3, 4 and 5 only. Okay, so Assam shares border with all northeastern states except Sikkim. So if a statement comes in future that Assam shares borders with all northeastern states, so that will be wrong because it doesn't touch its border with Sikkim and countries like Bhutan and Bangladesh. So you can see here in map, this is very important, that here is Arunachal Pradesh, here is Sikkim, here is Assam. See, Assam is having border with all the northeastern states. Okay, Nagaland is here, then here it is Manipur, then Mizoram, then here it is Tripura, then here it is Meghalaya, and in the center it is Assam. Okay, so you try to remember such kind of things and do keep revising map. Okay, so moving on, question number 49. With reference to Indian economy, public sector enterprise are designated with different status. Which of the following PSEs are Maharatnas? So here it is asking about Maharatna PSEs. Okay, so Steel Authority of India, it is definitely there. Bharat Electronics Limited, this is not there. So easily we can eliminate A, C and D option. So we are left with B. So B is the correct answer. GAIL and BHEL both are there. Okay, so answer is B, 1, 3, 4. Okay, so these, the table which you can see here, these all companies are Maharatna. Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, Coal India Limited, IOCL, NTPC, ONGC, SAIL, BPCL, GAIL. Okay, whereas Bharat Electronics Limited is a Navratna company. Okay, so answer is B. Moving on, question number 50. Consider the following statements. India shares its longest land border of around 4,000 km with Bangladesh, followed by Pakistan. So this is not correct. So A cannot be the answer. Border Security Force guards the border between India and Pakistan. So this is correct. Okay, so answer will be from C and D. B also cannot be the answer. No Central Armed Police Force guards India-Nepal border since it is open border between both countries. No. This is not correct. There is one CAPF which guards the India-Nepal border. So answer is D, 2 only. Okay, so answer is D. So here you can see, you just memorize this table. It is very, very important that longest border India has with Bangladesh, then with China, देन विथ पाकिस्तान, देन नेपाल, देन म्यांमार, देन भूटान, देन अफगानिस्तान. ओके, सो टोटल लैंड बॉर्डर ऑफ इंडिया इज़ अराउंड 15,000 किलोमीटर एंड टोटल मेरीन बॉर्डर ऑफ इंडिया इज़ अराउंड 7,000 किलोमीटर एंड हाइएस्ट लॉन्गेस्ट बॉर्डर इज़ विथ बांग्लादेश एंड देन विथ चाइना. ओके, सो इंडिया हैज़ 15,106 किलोमीटर ऑफ लैंड बॉर्डर एंड अ कोस्ट लाइन ऑफ 7,516. एंड दिस पाकिस्तान एंड बांग्लादेश बॉर्डर आर गार्डेड बाई बी एस एफ, चाइना बॉर्डर बाई आई टी बी पी, म्यांमार बॉर्डर बाई असम राइफल्स, नेपाल एंड भूटान बॉर्डर बाय सशस्त्र सीमा बल एस एस बी, एंड इंडियन आर्मी गार्ड्स लैंड बॉर्डर्स अलॉन्ग एल ओ सी ऑन पाकिस्तान बॉर्डर एंड एल ए सी ऑन चाइना बॉर्डर, एंड इंडियन नेवी एंड कोस्ट गार्ड आर वेस्टेड विथ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ कोस्टल बॉर्डर्स, वेर एज स्टेट मेरीन पुलिस एक्ट एज सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस. ओके, सो मूविंग ऑन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 51. With reference to Indian economy, consider the following statements. GDP growth rate of India at constant price is steadily increasing from last decade. No, this is wrong, because it is very, very simple that GDP of India is not constantly increasing. It is like fluctuating, increasing, decreasing, decreasing, increasing. Okay. So the first statement is wrong. Second statement, present base year for GDP calculation is 2011-12. So this is correct. So answer here is B. Okay, so answer is B. GDP growth rate of India at constant price is not steadily increasing from last decade. And here it is given description, so you can read about it. Okay, moving on. Question number 52. Which of the following measures is are examples of expansionary fiscal policy? Expansionary fiscal policy means that government will increase its expenditure. Okay. Fiscal policy is related to government. You should know these basics. And monetary policy is related to RBI. Okay. So in expansionary fiscal policy, government will run many schemes, give lot of money to people. So basically, at the end, what will happen? Money supply will increase. Okay, so decrease in tax rate. Yeah, this is correct, because if tax rate will decrease, people will have more money in their hands. So one is correct. So A and B cannot be the answer. Okay, increase in pension. Okay, this is also correct, because if pension is there, people will again have more money in their hands. Increase in unemployment compensation. Yeah, this is also there. And increase in tax rate. If tax rate will increase, people will have to pay more tax and they will have less money in their hands. Okay, so 4 cannot be there. So answer is C, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so answer is C. And expansionary is a macroeconomic policy that seeks to encourage economic growth or combat inflationary price increase by expanding the money supply, lowering interest rate, increasing government spending or cutting taxes. Okay, increasing the tax rate is not an example of expansionary fiscal policy. Okay, moving on, question number 53. Consider the following statements. From last two fiscal years, food subsidies provided by the central government is greater than fertilizer subsidies. Yeah, this is correct, because food subsidies are always more than fertilizer subsidy. Interest payment would be a major expenditure of government according to budget 2019-20. Yeah, this is also correct. In India, budget is prepared by Department of Expenditure under Ministry of Finance. This is a very basic statement. Many of you might be knowing, and if you don't know, then it is very bad. Okay, budget is prepared by Department of Economic Affairs. Okay, so answer is A, 1 and 2 only. So answer is A. So here you can see in subsidies, food subsidy is having the largest share, then fertilizer, then petroleum, then interest subsidy, and then others. And budget is prepared by Department of Economic Affairs under Ministry of Finance. Okay, so in this diagram is very important. Here you can see that the most money to government comes from corporation tax and then GST. Corporation tax and GST both are having same share. Okay, then it is followed by borrowings, market borrowings and all those things. Then it is followed by income tax. Okay, so you remember till here. And the expenditure part, when it is discussed, then money of government goes mostly to state share. Okay, 42% tax revenue is shared by and central government with state government, and then it goes to in interest payment. Okay, so this is it. Moving on. Question number 54. Consider the following statements. Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi intended to provide direct income support to all farmers at the rate of 6,000 per year. So if you have read this statement or heard this statement nicely, you can see it is saying about all farmers. So yesterday only I said about these all, never, not, always. So these kind of statements are most of the time wrong. So this is wrong. Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan aims to provide unorganized sector workers a comprehensive social security coverage for their old age. So this is correct. Okay, so answer is B. So answer is B. Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme, it aims to provide direct income support at rate of 6,000 per year to whom? Small and marginal farmers. Okay, so small and marginal farmers are those who have land less than 2 acres. Okay, and it will help around, it will benefit around 12 crore small and marginal farmer families, and this 6,000 rupees will be given in 3 installments of rupees 2,000 each. Whereas Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan, it will cover unorganized sector workers. This scheme will cover all unorganized sector workers with income less than 15,000. Okay, this is also important. With income less than 15,000, this pension yojana shall provide them an assured monthly pension of rupees 3,000 from the age of 60 year on a monthly contribution of a small affordable amount during their working age. Means you make some contribution when you are working, and after the age of 60 years, you will get rupees 3,000 as monthly pension. So moving on, question number 55. Doha development agenda is sometimes in news. Is okay. So it is the trade negotiation round of the WTO. Objective was to lower trade barriers around the world. So answer here is A. Okay. So answer is A. The Doha development round or Doha development agenda is the trade negotiation round of the World Trade Organization, which commenced in November 2001 under then Director General Mike Moore. Its objective was to lower trade barriers around the world and thus facilitate increased global trade. Okay friends, we will stop here. So I am not getting very good response from your side. So please, if you like this video, do like it and share it with your friends, because this might help them. And do post your score in the comment section below, that how many questions you got correct. All right, thank you, all the best.